Excuse me, cook, sir. May I please have some more?
What did you say, boy?
I asked you if I could have just a little more.
You ungrateful little gutter snipe.
What's going on?
He asked for more tuck. I could hardly believe my ears.
How dare you even think of such a thing? It's unheard of.
I'm sorry, sir, but we're all so hungry.
You wait till I get my hands on you.
I'm taking you to the council.
No, not the council. No.
Oh, lovely.
Go to play and have a look
with Rosie's bag,
Jim's drawing book,
the world to spy,
the window frame, and Rosie and Jim, we play our games. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, finding stories every day. Rosie and Jim, Rosie and Jim, and Johnny writes them down.
To stop at the station to let off passengers.
Peep, peep, peep!
Quickly, please, called Thomas. And off they went again. Come along, sang Thomas. We're coming along, sang Annie and Clarabel. Hurry, 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 pouted Thomas. Then he looked ahead. There was Bertie tooting triumphantly on his horn. Oh, dearie me, groaned Thomas.
London in the England of the 1830s, the decade when Charles Dickens wrote the greatest part of his work, dedicated to children, of whom he remains a great friend through his stories. Dickens tells of the customs of his time, on many pages crowded with interesting personalities and exciting adventures, where children often play a major part. In his work, Dickens captures brotherhood, poetry, and love, values which are beginning to be lost. His great heart, his noble ears.
Today you gave me all the art.